I'm Jacqueline Nolis. This is my presentation, how one time I made an entire e-commerce platform on Shiny. They said it couldn't be done, but I did it. What is that platform? That platform is GGIRL, which is to make your GG plots in real life. Some people may pronounce it G-girl, but it is officially GGIRL. You can install it via remotes, install GitHub, JNolis, GGIRL, and what it does, it lets you take a GG plot you've made that's beautiful, that you wish existed in the physical realm. You can then pay a modest fee, and very soon you will get an actual postcard delivered to a friend or family member. But it's all cool to talk about it. Let's actually see how it works instead. So I'm going to immediately switch out of PowerPoint and switch to a live demo. So I'm running this in Saturn Cloud. I'm just going to open up RStudio. And so let's say you have a plot you like. Like, let's say you have this souvenir commemorative RStudio. Oh, no. I think we're also, yeah, we're missing it. Is it not showing up? Wait, here, can I do this? Yeah. Cool, good, that would have been tragic because of the best part. Here we go, let's see if I can do this from over here, yes. Okay, great. Let's say you have this souvenir commemorative GGIRL plot. Oh God, I'm gonna have to do it like this. Oh no, I see it, we're good, okay. So you have this souvenir commemorative GGIRL plot. You can then go and you can use this GG postcard function, which takes a plot, the contact email for the order confirmation, the message you want to put on the back of the postcard, like this is a great conference, thanks for putting on, and the address of a friend or family member. In this case, I'm going to send it to our friends at RStudio, I mean Posit, in Boston, Massachusetts. So in several weeks, their headquarters is going to be confused why they got a postcard. But here we are. So I'm going to hit that, and what's going to happen is it's going to think for a second, and then it's going to launch an entirely separate Shiny server. This is a Shiny server running somewhere else. It is not running on my computer. It is running actually on Saturn Cloud. So in the front, you can see the preview of the postcard. It shows you the message. It shows you the address. It has one button, and that's pay and submit. When you hit pay and submit, oh God, this is so hard. There we go. Okay, great. When you hit pay and submit, it thinks for a second and sends you to Stripe. In Stripe, it asks you for money. So I'm going to go ahead and put in my credit card information. Just kidding, cyber stalkers. So you do that, and then if you did somehow put in your credit card information in front of a bunch of people, you would then very soon get an email confirming that you made the order. In 1 to 2 weeks, you will get a physical postcard of your GG plot. That's right, the first presentation you've seen with physical props. Your message is on the back, it's got the GGIRL hex sticker. Oh, I think I just doxed myself and my address. Cool, okay, so now we're back to PowerPoint and let's see if I can pop this back up. Let me see, you got it? Okay, great, cool. Cool, so that was the demo. As you saw, it went from R to a Shiny app to Stripe and then somehow a postcard appeared. But how does it work? How does it work? How does it work? There we go. How does it work? Okay, so there's a R package called GGIRL. That's what you install on your computer and talks to Shiny server. And then there's a Shiny server called GGIRL server, which does all the work of showing the user preview, passing the information to Stripe, fulfilling the postcard via an API, so there's a service somewhere I call to make the postcard go, and then sends a confirmation email. Now, if you think about it, GGIRL server should be multiple Shiny apps and Plumber APIs. There's no reason why the fulfillment, why the uploading the information should be done via Shiny. It's better, probably better to do that as an API via Plumber. But for ease of maintenance, I'm like, I really just want one Shiny app to do all of this. And by ease of maintenance, I mean I'm super lazy and I don't want to have to keep a bunch of microservices running. I just want one. But to make this work leads a lot of engineering questions, which I'm going to enumerate now. One is, how do you pass the plot from R to Shiny? If you think about it, Shiny, there's a lot of times where Shiny has data loaded into it, right? You can read data from a database in Shiny. You can press the upload button on Shiny. But if you think about it, there's not really an obvious way that if a Shiny server is running, how can you programmatically send data to it? So I don't want it to read data on load. I want to just pass the data to a server that's running. It may not even have a web page open. I just want it to listen for data. So the way you would do that in, like, web development land is you do an HTTP post request. So an HTTP post request is a way an API or a website receives data. So when you hit submit on like a website, your browser is doing a post request to the server. That should be done with a post request. Shiny does not have the ability to, a documented ability to listen for post requests. Normally only Plumber does that. It should have this, and that's my call out to RStudio, I mean, pause it. I think that would be a really great feature. The good news is there's actually a number of undocumented ways to do this. And so again, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to post the image to Shiny. So here's the plot I've made. And then I want Shiny to come back to me with, okay, here's the ID of that image. I'm like, cool, I got the image, I'm gonna call it FC whatever. And then the package is gonna be like, okay, cool, I'm then gonna take the user to the browser website to actually do the preview. So this is a back and forth of the post request. So there are a number of undocumented ways to do this. The way I like the most is you use the brochure package by Colin Fay. This is an experimental package that lets you connect multiple Shiny apps together. So if you have like three different Shiny apps and you're like, man, I really wish all of them were running at once, you can bundle them all up into one Shiny app using brochure. You can also listen to requests besides get. So if you want to have your Shiny app listen for data, not just show web pages, brochure will let you do that too. So this actually solves two of my problems. One, it lets me listen for post data. And two, I can actually have a bunch of concurrent Shiny apps, one for the order upload, one for the fulfillment, one for the preview. It's so new, it doesn't even have a hex sticker. It also says all over it, experimental, do not use in production. But here I am using in production, and it's working great. Thanks, Colin. If you want to see examples of the other ways that are actually built into Shiny to do post requests, I have a link at the bottom and you can check it out. Cool. So how do you show the image preview? So once we have the data uploaded into Shiny, how do we show the image? Well, this is actually just a Shiny app with one button. What I do is I have the URL you go to, have the token, which is the ID of the particular postcard you uploaded. I have that in the URL, and then the Shiny server shows a different postcard depending on what your token is. Now, I put a lot of work into the bootstrap and the CSS to make it all look pretty and to get the margins on the postcard right and all that. I have a whole separate talk about making your Shiny apps look pretty that I gave at ShinyConf 2022. So if you want like 45 minutes of hearing about how to make your Shiny apps look pretty, I suggest you check out that talk. It was a lot of fun. So okay, cool. So we have a Shiny app. It shows you the preview of the thing. It got the data from a post request from R. But how do we then pass the user from Shiny to Stripe, right? How do I make that pay and submit button send someone to Stripe? I thought this would be the hardest part of the app, but it actually was surprisingly easy to make this. There are really just two steps in the payment flow. First is you need Shiny to send Stripe what is actually in the shopping cart of the user, which is called the Stripe session. You do this via a post request. By the way, it turns out GGIRL is like 95% just post requests bouncing around, and this is another one, it's not the last. You then also, once you've posted the cart, you then have to have the user go to the Shiny page, or the Stripe page. So Stripe has a JavaScript API to get users to the appropriate Stripe checkout page. I refuse to learn JavaScript. I will never do this. The good I'm not alone here. Great. The good news is that Shiny makes it very easy, I found out, to use other people's JavaScript APIs. So what you do is you add tags $script to the top of your Shiny app to load in the JavaScript API, and then use shiny.custom message handler so that when the action button is pressed for pay and submit, it will call that special JavaScript. So it's really just two steps. And again, if you want to see the particular code, you can go to that GGIRL examples repo and you can see an example there. So this gets the user from Shiny to Stripe, where they presumably pay money because they are excited about a postcard. How do you then fulfill the order? So how do you have Shiny then listen for Stripe being like, okay, cool, they paid you money, now we're gonna go ahead and make the order. So we do this with a post request. So we're gonna have Stripe send a post request telling Shiny to order the postcards. So if your server is listening for someone else's post request, that is called a webhook. It's just a different name for another post request. It's just kind of going in the other direction. So we're gonna use a webhook saying, hey, order XYZ or FC6, whatever the order number is, has been paid for. And to make sure that like people just don't know what that URL is and spam it to get a million postcards, we are gonna add keys to ensure that the message actually came from Stripe itself. So Shiny will receive the request and be like, okay, cool, the order is placed, and then Shiny will call the stuff to send the postcard and send the email. This feels like it should be straightforward, right? I've already done two or three post requests as part of this talk. This is just another post request. But here's the issue, is that Stripe needs to know that the message was received really quickly. So if Stripe says the order was confirmed, and Stripe doesn't hear right away that the order actually, like, your app go, like, cool, we got the order, should be like, oh my God, they didn't hear it. I gotta send it again. And here's the thing you might know about Shiny, is Shiny takes a while when it's running stuff. So if you're not, you guys are putting it together. Yes, this took me a while, too long to put together, that if you're not careful, Stripe will ask for the order to be submitted over and over, and Shiny will be like, cool, got it, cool, got it, cool, got it. And the next thing you know, you have 20 postcards sent to your house. So the trick to solve this is you're going to use caller package. And caller's a really cool package to run our processes in the background. So when you get the order from Stripe, you're going to use caller to send, like, actually send the postcard, send the email. That's all going to happen in the background so that Shiny can immediately respond to Stripe being like, yeah, cool, we got it, and not be bogged down by the time it takes to send the postcard and to submit the postcard order and send the email. I love using caller so much from learning this that I actually made a whole talk about using R in parallel, which is a separate thing. If you want to learn about that, I have a separate talk for this. And if you actually want to just see the code that does this, again, GGIRL examples has that. So to actually fulfill the order, I needed to use caller to run R in the background. And then to order the postcards, it turns out there are like tons of companies out there that will make APIs that if you hit that API with a post request, with the message, the address, and the front of the postcard, they will ship it to that location. This makes sense because you get lots of postcards in the mail for advertisements. So lots of companies use these services. Two problems here. One, it takes a while to ship postcards, right? It takes like 2 weeks to ship postcards. So it takes a while before you actually get the postcard back. And two, companies that are sending millions of postcards to every person in the country don't care really how good the postcards look as long as they're cheap. So it took forever for me to find a service that was actually good. And so it took 2 weeks and I didn't like it. And 2 weeks and I didn't like it. And in fact, if you see over there, if you see in this image on the presentation, it looks kind of blurry. It looks like kind of like JPEG artifacts. Like this was like a Facebook meme that got sent to you too many times. That was not this picture I uploaded. That's what it actually looked like on the postcard. And that is beneath the dignity of ggplot2 plots. So I had to spend a while, but by far this is the longest part, because I had to spend a while until I find a printing service that was actually good. To send the confirmation emails, this is actually pretty easy. There's a package, Blastula, which can send those emails. So all I had to do to put the preview in the email is I wanted to resize it, because those images had to be very large for the printer, and I wanted to resize them so they weren't like 5 megs in your inbox. So I used the package Image Magic to resize them and get the right margins and everything. But sometimes there would be an error in the fulfillment. So not only did I have to send an email to the users, but if anything ever goes wrong, I wanted to make sure I caught it, so I'd have to send an email to me. And once in a while, the email system would have an error in emailing, so I had to email about that too. It was a real web of emails being sent. So lastly, how do you actually deploy it? So I needed the server to actually be, that GGIRL server, the Shiny app, had to be continuously living somewhere. So the place it is currently running is on Saturn Cloud. So Saturn Cloud, I'm the chief product officer of the company. And so it's really nice for this. I know it's a, I'm an advertiser. So it was actually very nice because I had two RStudio servers running in Saturn Cloud in the cloud. So one is the one I actually was showing you, which is like how I did the development of the Shiny package in RStudio in a browser. But I also had a RStudio running for developing the Shiny backend, and then I actually had two Shiny servers running on Saturn Cloud. One, the actual server, the Shiny server you saw, the production one, but as well as a development one that I could test with and use like fake credit cards and it would fake send emails. So I ended up having four systems all running on Saturn Cloud, which was pretty nice and easy. And most importantly, I beta tested this with a bunch of people to make sure it worked first, and that took a while and helped me really iron out some usability issues, and that was really nice as well. So wrapping it all up, GGIRL is a cool package for ordering cool stuff. This required me to do a bunch of things that I assumed might be true in Shiny, but I didn't actually know, and it turns out it is, which includes receiving data from an R package, listening for post requests, sending and receiving Stripe API calls, and spawning background processes that didn't slow down the Shiny responsiveness. I forgot to mention, thank you. I forgot to mention in the beginning that not only can you send GG postcards, but you can also order art prints for your walls, which people have used for like graduation presents and stuff, which is really cool. And people use, oh, by the way, people use like GG postcards for like baby announcements and stuff. People get really clever uses for these, so it's a lot of fun. And there's GG watercolor, which is just, I hand paint a watercolor for you if you want it. So you can install the package with the GG Nolis JGIRL, that's not me, J Nolis GGIRL. You can actually, if you want to make one of your own souvenir commemorative postcards, the code's linked above. The examples of the code in practice from the production server are at the GGIRL examples. And if you want to see the slides, that's the link. But lastly, I have a whole bunch of coupons for 80% off, which means you can get a postcard sent for 50 cents, which is the cheapest Stripe will allow me to do before saying I can't do that. So if you come talk to me after, I have so many of these coupons to give out because I'm really excited for people to use this. So, okay, thank you. Thank you.